glorious time in the Lord. Amen. I want you to know that this is Church of God, 14901 South Honore in Harvey, Illinois. Our telephone number is 333-1441, 331-9306. The Church of God is right.
Yes, it is. Amen.
It's the Bible name for church.
Yes, it is. Amen.
Hmm? It's in your Bible.
Yes, it is.
It's in your Bible. Now you get ready for the word. This is what it's going to take to save you.
Amen.
Saying it all right. Amen. Rejoice and goes along with it. But it's going to take your word to do the job.
Amen.
Hmm?
Amen.
I said the Church of God is right. It's Bible all the way.
Yeah.
And Paul had brought the ministers, and there was 12 ministers that he was talking to in Acts 20 and 28. Take heed therefore to yourself and to all the flock that the Holy Ghost have made you overseer to feed the Church of God. That's the Bible name. Apostle Paul 10:32, give no offense neither to the Jews nor to the Gentiles, not unto the Church of God. 1 Timothy 3:5. Mm-hmm. If a man know not to rule his own house, how can he take care of the Church of God?
Yeah.
Now these scriptures is in your Bible.
Yeah.
It's in prophecy, it's also in your Bible.
Yeah.
Now if you like to have these scriptures, what you call us, write us. We'd be too glad to send these scriptures to you. And I want you to know that we're yet preaching the same thing.
Yeah.
We have to change our text. We don't have to change our text. We know that ministers and pastors are changing.
Oh, yeah.
Amen. But I tell you, Hebrews 13:8 said, Jesus Christ the same yesterday, today, and forevermore.
Yeah.
If Jesus never changed, his word would never change. If holiness was right 20, 30, 40 years ago, it's still right.
Amen.
If the Holy Ghost was right then, it's still right.
Amen.
Hmm? There's no change. The folks have changed, but the word hasn't changed. We are to stick with the book. And the next verse, Paul said, be not carried away with divers and strange doctrine.
Yes.
And this is what happened now. So many of you that came from Mississippi and Alabama, and you came up to this big city and you got carried away with strange doctrine.
Amen.
Praise God, going after strange gods. And many of you listening to me right now used to be in the Church of God in Mississippi and Alabama.
All right.
And you came to this big city, praise God, and you know, went off in the woods.
Yeah.
And tangled up, praise the Lord, in the jungle.
Yeah.
And bring it up in false doctrine.
Yeah.
I want you to know that God is not pleased with that.
Yeah.
Amen. You need to come on back home.
Yeah.
You need to come on back home. That's what you need to do. Come on back home and do that thing all over again. Because you know the word of God is right. I'm talking to you, woman, that man, that woman listening right now. Praise God, the word is talking to you. You need to get on up and come on back to the Church of God. Praise God is not pleased with it. Thank God for Jesus. Now, many of you have been to early morning service. You have been to early morning service. Many of you was at the early service on Easter Sunday morning. Huh? And many of you are here today, and many folks will go to church and haven't been there since the last holiday.
Amen.
Hmm?
Amen. My Lord.
Praise God.
Mm-hmm.
But I want you to know that early morning service you have gone to and it's been there at 6 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah.
It didn't do you no good because you left there and come right on back to the whiskey bottle.
Go ahead.
You left there and went on back to your cigarettes.
Yeah.
Huh? You left there and went right on back to Ann's house.
Yeah.
And you're still doing the same old thing that you've been doing all the time.
Yeah.
Hmm? I want you to know that that will not save you.
Yeah.
And many of you are going right on back to the disco.
Yeah.
Hmm? I'm talking about folks, church folks. You see, what you really need is a good cleaning job.
Yeah.
You need to be clean.
Yeah.
of Christ and the death of Christ brought us a new day. Brought us a new day. Come on, Rita. Praise God. You out there, get your Bibles. And many of you out there that haven't picked your Bible up and read it in months and some years. The dust on settle. Now, this is not the kind of preaching you're used to. You heard Daniel in the lion's den, eagle stirring a nest. And you throw your purses away, and you go right on back to doing the same thing you've been doing all the time. Amen. But listen, the kind of preaching that we're going to give you today will make you fight man or fight land.
Amen.
It's time to tell the folks the truth.
Amen.
False prophets, blind guides, it's time to tell the truth.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Praise God. Some of you just carry away all these TV preachers. They're just your favorite preachers. Amen. You're sending them all your money. Amen. You don't know what kind of life you're living.
Amen.
Huh? Praise God. I don't know what you're doing with your money. Amen. But you're in love with the TV preacher.
Amen.
Huh? And they're letting you down, and when them have let you down, they fall and they still fall.
Amen.
Mm, praise the Lord. I tell you, you need to turn to Jesus.
Amen.
You need to turn to the truth of the Word of God.
Right.
You shall know the truth, and the truth shall do what? Make you free. Bless God. Now, get your Bible there. We're going to the book of Romans. Thank God for the Word.
Amen.
The sixth chapter, beginning at the first verse.
What shall we say then?
What shall we say then?
Shall we continue in sin that grace may abound?
Apostle Paul asked in the church a question.
Uh-huh.
Shall we continue in sin? And let me ask you the question out there in radio land. Should you continue in sin? Mm-hmm. And saying that you know the man, and you are a Christian.
Yeah.
Christian means Christ-like.
Yeah.
Huh? Christ-like.
Yeah.
So many of you saying, I'm a Christian and don't know what the word means.
Amen.
God forbid.
Now, Apostle Paul said, God forbid for you to continue to live in sin.
Mm-hmm. How shall we that are dead to sin live any longer therein?
How shall we that are dead? And that's the whole problem now. There's not enough dead folks.
Amen.
In the church.
Yeah. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Live folks, but he talks about dead folks.
Amen.
Naturally so, when a man dies, naturally so, you know, he don't have no communication with life.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Praise the Lord. You can holler at him, you can feel him, and you can do whatever you want, praise God. He's not going to respond to it.
Yeah.
Because he's dead.
Yeah.
When you dead to sin, you don't have no connection with sin.
Yeah.
In other words, you don't practice sin any longer.
Yeah.
You don't constantly do those things any longer. Why? Because Christ is coming to your life.
Yeah.
Now, we're talking about the resurrection of Christ. It's more than just going to church on Easter Sunday.
Yeah.
It's more than just singing in the choir.
Yeah.
Huh? You know you're not living right.
Yeah.
Well, some of you listen to me. You're used to this old time preaching. Praise God, but you done got carried away over the eagle.
Yeah.
All right.
But the eagle bread won't save your soul.
Yeah.
Huh? Yeah. Then the lion then it won't help you.
Yeah.
You need Bible salvation.
Yeah.
Praise God, huh?
No, you not that as many of us as baptized into Jesus Christ were baptized unto his death.
Was baptized unto his death.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, we are bearing with him by baptism.
We are bearing with him by baptism. You see, when a man is baptized, he's supposed to be changed his way.
Yeah.
Huh? in this new life.
Yeah.
All right, Christ have role in your life, then your life should change.
Amen.
You should have a new walk in Jesus.